Welcome. Today we are going to learn how you can start getting more likes and engagement on your Instagram posts. My name is Valerie. I am a social media expert and Instagram influencer. I love sharing my tips with you guys, and if you are looking to grow your Instagram or learn more about marketing yourself, this is the place for you. I'm excited to get into this. And also, if you want to see more videos like this that are informational with tips, tricks, and hacks, then this is the place for you. Hit that subscribe button and you'll see more videos just like this one. I also wanted to recommend that you watch this video to the end to fully understand how your followers work and how to really get that high engagement from them. And other than that, let's get into it. Feel free to leave a like. So my first tip for you guys is to post vertical images instead of horizontal or squared on Instagram. So why am I even saying this? And it's not just because it's a preference or because it maybe looks better, but it's actually because when you post a vertical image, I have an example right now on the screen, you take up more space in the Instagram feed. So that is exactly why you should be doing that. When you are posting a square or a horizontal photo, then first of all, your photo does not take a lot of the screen. And second of all, your photo is a lot easier to be scrolled by because already it's not taking up the full space of the Instagram real estate, but it's really just half, or you can have two squared images, right, in one feed when you're actually going through the newsfeed. So I hope this makes sense. You just want to have a vertical photo because it takes up more space in the feed when your followers are actually viewing your photo, so it actually gains more attention, right? So when you're scrolling and you see a photo that is vertical, it takes up a lot more of the screen and you just give more attention to that. So that is one little hack that I wanted to share with you guys. I personally only post vertical images most of the time just because of that reason. And just the way Instagram has given us this opportunity to post vertical images, comparing that to the squared images back in the day, if you actually know Instagram for that long, we only used to have squared images, but now we have vertical option, and I recommend you take advantage of that. All right, and now to tip number two. This is a big one, like one of the biggest ones I would say from these tips. So what I recommend and I highly stress is to leave a call to action under all of your posts. So what is a call to action? A call to action is when you are motivating your follower, your viewer, your audience to actually do something at the end of the post. So what is your call to action? You have to think about that for yourself. Is it for them to go watch your stories, or is it for them to go click the link in your bio? Is it to leave a like? So specifically in our situation here, and we are trying to get more likes for our photos, I recommend you tell your followers to leave a like at the end of that post. And that really is actually going to give you such a high conversion, because when you don't actually tell your followers what to do, there's a big chance that they're not even going to leave a like after they read your whole caption because you did not even tell them what to do. So you just want to have that at the end, and people will listen, your followers will listen, and you will see the conversion on your Instagram. So take this tip, write it down in your notes, you guys. This is going to be key because this will change your conversion and this will attract more likes when you leave a call to action at the end of your caption. And also, I wanted to do a little hack from Val. You can use a caption break to make your captions even more aesthetic. This is a little add-on which can make it easier for your followers to read your captions. And what you need to add to your post is a caption break. So first, let me show you guys the difference between a post with a caption break and without a caption break right here. And you can see the difference because it's visually better to read a post when it has a caption break in it. So all you have to do is go to your phone. I will leave the link to this website in the description below, and all you have to do is copy and paste this line break that we have from this website. And all you have to do when you go into your caption is paste it in the middle and delete all the line breaks in between. So you want to have just your post and like this. So you just want to have the line break, which is invisible, and have the line break in between those two spaces in here. So that's what we do. And then you copy and paste that to Instagram and you have a line break that is beautiful and aesthetic and is visually pleasing to actually read. And also, I wanted to ask you guys, do you use call to action in your posts right now? Is that something you guys have been considering or doing? And if you do, tell me and share in the comments below what kind of call to actions you use for your audience. I'm really interested to see if you guys are using this technique already. So share below in the comments section and I'd love to hear from you. So tip number three is to engage with your audience within 30 minutes. And why do I say 30 minutes? It's because when you first publish a post on Instagram, the first 30 minutes is when the algorithm really determines if it's going to be showing your post to a lot of your audience or to a very small amount. And this factor depends on how much engagement you will get within your post. So when you comment back to your comments, this actually counts as engagement. So that's very good because this can start showing your post to more people, which equals more likes. Please don't ghost your posts when you post them on Instagram. That's something you don't want to do. Be present for the first 30 minutes at least, and after that you can take a break and not be on Instagram as much, but the first 30 minutes is the factor that determines how much people will see your post. So you want to engage as much with the comments and maybe even ask your followers to leave a comment below as well, because that will count as more engagement. And that is another effective way to bring more likes to your posts. Tip number four is to have informative captions. What are informative captions in the first place? It is when you're giving your followers value within your post. This can be in the form of a tutorial, or it can be something like giving your followers tips in the caption. So that is super important, because when you're giving value and informational content to your followers, they will see that and they actually engage a lot more. There will be more saves on your posts and you'll see the difference. I recommend you guys try this, because when I post something that is informational, and not just a post with a cute quote, but when it actually has value behind it, I see so much more engagement and lots of saves in my posts. These are just some of my informational post examples. I sometimes do tips, I do hacks, I also do tutorials for editing, and you guys can do something like that. You can do outfit inspirations if you do fashion. If you do fitness, I highly recommend doing a workout for people that they can use, so you can record videos with that. So there's lots of ways you guys can create something for yourself, for your brand, for your personal page that actually has content that's valuable behind it. Take advantage of this technique and put it into action in your next post. And if you guys actually want to hear more on informative captions and some ideas that you guys can implement, I will create a video with 10 ideas you can use in your Instagram for informative captions and posts that will actually bring more leads, more engagement, and how to create that informational content. If you guys want that video, I will do it if we can get this video to 1,000 likes, and if that happens, I will create it for you guys. Let's do it. If you wanna see a video with 10 tips and ideas for your informational posts, go ahead and leave a like below. And for our fifth and last step in getting more likes on your Instagram photos, I recommend creating high quality photos. Hear me out, you guys. Instagram is a visual platform. So when somebody is looking on your feed, on your Instagram post, in their newsfeed, the first thing they notice is the picture. So then they look at the caption. That is a fact. Your photo really has to grasp that follower to leave a like or to even look at your posts. I recommend having photos that are well lit, sharpened, edited with some kind of filter, and I recommend using my own presets. Check them out. I will leave the link below as well. And also add creativity to your photos so they're just not the basic photos that everyone sees. Go on Pinterest, get some creativity, and create something that's beautiful and people actually want to look at. Use these five tips and you will see a difference in the amount of likes you'll be getting on your Instagram. And also, I have an exclusive PDF guide that I've created for you guys with hacks to Instagram growth organically. So this is a product that people actually pay money for, and I'm giving it to you guys for free. All you have to do is download it in the description below. And inside there is a guide to growing your followers for free with zero investment, and all you have to do is apply the techniques that I share with you guys. So check it out, I have it linked below. Now leave a like below, because you just found out five ways that you can attract more likes on your Instagram posts. In this video, I shared five ways that you can attract more likes to your posts just by using these tricks, and they're organic. So none of these require fake likes and bots, which will not help you grow anywhere. This is all organic, and it is actually great for your Instagram and will increase your engagement. You have to post rectangular photos, have a call to action at the end of all your posts, engage with your post within 30 minutes on Instagram, have informative captions, questions, and also don't forget about the quality of your images. If you still haven't subscribed, click the subscribe button below so you guys don't miss any more tips and hacks that I share with you guys. Also, follow me on Instagram. I have lots of informational content on there within my posts, within tutorials, and also I can answer more questions that you may have in my DMs and also in my story and interactive posts. So go ahead and check that out. I have lots of faith in you. I know you will be successful because you are already searching for answers and looking for ways to grow. And I know that if you can apply these hacks, these tips that I've given you in this video, you will see results. So go ahead and take action with these tips. Feel free to click on more videos to watch more informational content from me, and I will see you in my next videos.